to make an income instead of having to venture out into the environment and causing conflicts. So we're able to sell those media products for them. The less cattle there are, the more food that's worth for the wildlife. So that's looking after them, but it's also looking after those people in the communities over there. So beforehand, when they were moving around, they had to live in houses like the ones to our right. Whereas now that they don't have to move around so much, they can build more permanent houses, more permanent communities. And they can even send all their children to school now as well. So that's obviously opening up a lot more opportunities for a lot more people as well.
Nãy nó làm cái hồ mới, con thấy hồi nãy cái hồ bự thì bự á, là cái hồ mới á.
So to give you a little bit of an idea on how big 82 acres is, we can fit an entire Melbourne Zoo in this savannah. And then we would still have plenty of room for car parking as well. As well as African animals, we do keep some magical animals in here as well. In fact, we keep a huge big dragon in here. So if you guys look out to the right hand side, look into this big old tree here, you'll be able to see our one-eyed tree dragon.
Wow, tree dragon.
actually see one of our boys having a little bit of a dust bath. And you can see he's flapping his wings about in the sand. He's rolling his neck around in it. So, and the reason he does that is to get rid of any insects and things like that that might be at the base of his feathers. So basically, like things like lice and mites and all those sorts of things. Because when he puts heaps of dirt in there, it doesn't leave a very good environment for those lice.